Hi, I'm Sahil, and let's start our new topic, which is array in JavaScript. So let's start it. Suppose you want to add all employees' name working in your organization. So what you will be doing, you will be creating a variable name for all the employees and then add it. I don't think this is a good approach. So what we will be doing in that scenario? So we will be creating an array of name employee and we will be adding it. So basically, it groups data together in a list or in an array index from 0. So if you want to retrieve second employee from this array employee, so you can retrieve using an employee 1. So basically the indexing start from 0, 1, 2 and 3. So it will print ln if you will do that. We can have empty array as well. Like suppose you declare a employee and you don't want to give any of the employees, so it will be empty array, or you can create using where employee and new array, so this will also an empty array. Array can hold all data types, so you can have random array, you can create with number type, boolean, even a null value and even a string value. Array have properties and method which can be used to perform various operations like length, if you want to get the length of the array, if you want to push some push any element in that array, you want to push, you can add element at the end, and pop will be the removing the element from the array. We will discuss this in upcoming slides, and in detail I will show you how the code is there. So let's go array function push and pop. Push is to add element at the end of the array, so you have this array and you want to push pink in this. Now if you push this, so your new array will be orange, blue, green, blue and pink. So this will be your new arrays. And suppose you want to pop something from your array, so pop is basically to remove last item from array. And if you do colors.color.pop, so it is going to remove the element which you have added. The pink was added at the last and now it is being removed as well if you use pop. There are some more operations which you can do on array, are unshaped, shaped, index of, slice and splice. So what are they? Unshaped can be used to add elements at the front of the array. Shift can be used to remove element from the front of the array. Index of can be used to find index of the item in an array. Slice can be used to copy part of an array. Splice can be used to remove element from an array. So these are the definitions of this, and I will be writing a code and I will be explaining you by writing some logic there, and you will be able to understand more. So let's first cover this slide and then we move to a code part. So now how you want to iterate an array. So you have array of color this, and you can use your for loop which we have already studied. Now from for loop for I equal to 0, colors dot length, and now colors, you give in colors the index which you want to print, so it will print in this way. Here one more if you have gone through the loops, so one more synthetic sugar has been added, giving a for each there, for each to us. For each basically is a recursive call, it is doing inside itself. You can see the syntax colors dot for each, and functions is there, and this is the color. So basically each time from these colors, one color will be picked in this function, will be gone in this function, will be gone, and it will print console.log in this way. So this is basically making your syntax it is same doing the same operation for was doing, but it's making your codes writing your code in less line, basically you can write that. So let's go to the coding part. Now we have already created this condition.js. now let's just create another file for arrays operations.js. Let's start then. Suppose you have an array here number. Now what you want to do, you want to print the length of an array. So what you will be writing, numbers dot length. So if you do dot intelligence, will show you like what all functions are there and what which you can perform here. So you have different functions, you can read about them and you can apply on your array. So I will be showing you how you will be counting the length of this. So now execute this file using node, which is already installed on your system. So you can see the length is this, and how you want to retrieve some element from your array. So you can do using numbers, and in between numbers you can write 3. Suppose you have given 3, and what you will think, like what will be the 3, whether it will be 33 or 98. It will be a 98. The reason is I already told the indexing of array will be started from 0. See, now going to the method which I told, like shown you, like push and pop. Let me comment it, and let's create an array with name color, and we have an array with this color. Let me remove this red, which is red duplicate. So let's do one thing, and we will be using colors dot push. You want to push some element in this. What will be the color? Light green. Let's do green. And suppose, let me comment this and we'll show you what this array contains. If you do console dot log let's print this and you can see. So you can see red, orange and yellow are there in this array, but when you push it green, so updated colors in an array you will be able to see. Like, so you can see, like earlier it was red, orange, green, and now green is added at the last. So this is the operations you have performed on array is push, and you have pushed a green color at the end of the array. Now you don't want this this green to be there. So what, how you can remove that? So simply write pop, so it will, let's print it as well. So pop will be just removing your last element green, which was added here, and it will be removing after pop. Let's execute it, and you can see like green is popped out from this array above, and now it is red, orange and yellow only. Let's use unshift now, because we have seen, like now you have already seen this. So let me comment this part of the code, and we will be saying like what is unshift. So I already told, like unshift, you want to unshift basically some color here. Black is good. So when you will unshift it, you do not print anything. So that's the reason. If you will print it, will show you the colors in your array, and the black will be added to the front of the array. So you can see here. So unshift is basically to add something at the front of the array. Like push was for the end, unshift is for the front. And similarly, you have a function shift, which is used to remove from the front of your array. So now let me print this. After shift, so now I added black at the first position of the color. You will be able to print it here from this line. Now I shift that. So shift means black will be removed, and my updated array will be the same which was there initially. So you can see black was removed and now red, orange and yellow is there. Okay, let's comment it and see the property index of you want, let's print it console.log, and then you want colors dot index of which color you want to get the index of. Suppose I want to get it for red, so let's print it and we'll see what is the index of red. So index of red is 0, orange is 1 and yellow is 2. Let's see that as well. Yellow, print yellow, so yellow will be 2. So we have read about another operations like slice and splice. So let's take another example, another array. Let me comment that. Let's take another example with the fruits array. So now you want to slice. So what was the slice? Slice was basically, let me show you in my slides only. Slice can be used to copy parts of your array, and splice is can be used to remove elements from your array. So now we will be using both of them. Let's write add citrus equal to fruits dot slice. So I want to slice from one to third position. So can anyone answer, like just think about like what, how it will be slicing this this fruit array from 1, 2, 3. So that means it will be picking element from its first position to lemon. So basically orange and lemon will be sliced from this array. So let's print it. Orange and lemon are sliced, and if you don't give any thing in this, suppose I don't want to give the number from where I want to slice, so it is going to copy everything from fruits to citrus basically. And suppose I give a negative, so negative means starting from the end. Let's see that as well. -1, so from end mango will be there, and mango is there. And if you want to print 2, so you can have 2, apple and mango. And suppose I give arbitrary number like 33, what you will think? It will give an error or something? It will print the full array for you, because starting from end to last it will print everything. Let's take example of splice now. Let's comment it. We have a fruit, sorry, we have this. Let's print this splice method example. It will modify your existing array. How? But so now you have, you create another variable with the new fruits. I liked it as new fruits. And you will be splicing it from 1, 2. So from 1, 2, orange and lemon will be coming in this, and write console.log. First we will see what all is there in fruits, and then we will be seeing what is there in new fruit. Let's do one thing. First print new fruit, because you are already making an operation on there, and then you want to see like how the fruits array is been updated. So you think like fruit array will remain the same or it will change? Basically it is going to get changed, because you have spliced, you have taken a copy of that from your existing array, and you have been assigned to this new fruit, and the remaining array was banana, orange and mango. You can see like you spliced this from there. So this is basically the thing, like these are the operations. So let me give you one exercise. If you want, like, you can perform it and it will clear your more concepts. So what you can do, you can take this as exercise and you can do it yourself, and you will see, like, I will, like, push my code for this exercise on my GitHub repository and you can check it from there. Create an array with red, orange and pink. If it contains orange, then remove pink. Sorry, it is pink. And from the array, and add yellow to the front. So here you will be using shift, unshift and index of to check whether where the element is present or not. So these all operations will be used in this exercise. Now from the updated array in step 2, check if it contains yellow. Then create a new array called these two values from the existing array. So basically you will be using all operations if you perform this exercise. So just try to perform this exercise and it will be helpful to you. And now coming to a for each syntax, like we already studied about for each, what is the for each and how you will be using that for each. Suppose you have colors in this way and you want call dot, now if you do dot, intelligence will show you for each, and just print it for each, and here this. So now it's element arrow function is this, and then you will be printing console dot. Let's make an e small for them and let's e for small. So this is a for each method where element will be there, and this is the arrow function, and the arrow function is same like a lambda in Java and C sharp. And the arrow function we will talk in details when we go to a TypeScript, and we will learn this in our upcoming slide. So just see, like you can see it has been printed here, and now like what I have shown you in my slides, it was related to like how we have been using this for it. So it is basically another way. If you don't want to use the array function, then you can use this. This is like the wrong characters. Let me have this array only. Something went wrong and let's print it console dot log dot. Color here and